Welcome back, everyone. That was a wonderful session on NEP, the Implementer's Perspective. Right now, we have Collaborative Action Towards Education Transformation by Shrutika Jatav. Over the years, Shrutika has worked directly with beneficiaries, set up operations for NGOs like Teach for India, liaised with government and other stakeholders to drive impact. Shrutika was also instrumental in the launch of India School Leadership Institute, the first school leadership training program in Mumbai. At Destra, Shrutika is part of the Adolescence Collaborative Team and supports organizations in their journey to impact. Shrutika, welcome, and over to you for the
session. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's really nice to be speaking to everyone today. Before I start my session, I just wanted to get a bit of a sense of who we have in our virtual room. So if you are a teacher, if I can request you to type teacher, if you are a principal, or then you can say principal. If you're an educator, so outside of working in the in a school, if you're a general educator, you can type educator. So let's take a couple of minutes and would love to know who's in the room. See, we of course have teachers. It's really great. Oh, and we have some students also. Okay, great. So that's helpful. It seems like most of us are teachers. And then, of course, there's a mix of sort of educators who are linked in the space and principals as well. I'll just start my session by giving a bit of a background on why this topic is really something I'm speaking to you about today, why it is important. And there is a key word here, which is education transformation. Now, when we're thinking about this, when we're talking about transforming education, it's a big word. And so it always gets us thinking, what does this mean? What is my role in that transformation and as such? And I think I got on this journey to think about education transformation when I was a teacher. So I was in a classroom, I was teaching about standard 2 and 3. And then as I was working with teachers, I realized that there's so much that the teachers do, but the environment, even in the school, to support the teachers has to be really something that's fulfilling as well. And so there's a role of the school principal that becomes important. And so there was a lot of conversation on teacher training, but very little conversation on working with principals. So from my experience as a teacher, I had a small part to play in launching this school principal training program, which was to make sure that as a principal, as teachers, we work together as a team for our students and our community. Then I was working for a few years in the principal training program, and I realized that there are so many systemic issues that make it difficult for a school principal and teachers to even fully operationalize or work within their school. Then these are different systemic issues: the community operate, the government rules, mandates, etc., curriculums. And there are lots of things that need to work. And it really got me thinking about that, okay, if we have to really make a difference or do this transformation, you cannot work only on one piece ourselves. We really have to work together as a team. And at the center of working together as a team is to keep our children and therefore our students. So that's where this idea of collaboration came. Collaboration simply means that how do we work together? And almost saying that we need to work together to make this change happen. So today I'm going to talk to you about three things: just why collaboration is important, what do we mean by it, so what can that mean for us as teachers, educators, principals, and then how can we make it happen. If time permits, I'd like to get into a little bit of an exercise with you as well. But let's start with a bit of a why, and I'd love to hear your thoughts at the end of this as to do you believe that this kind of collaboration is really even possible. But this quote, which says that the whole is greater than the sum of its parts, it's a very old quote. Some of you may have heard it. You can give me a thumbs up if you have heard it, or a plus or a yes if you've heard it before. But basically, this is a philosophical quote which goes back thousands of years, but is used even today to give us a message that agar hum hamara efforts combine kare, agar each of us separately, if we come together, then you know, change is inevitable. We can achieve what we want to achieve. And there are a lot of examples in our modern, recent world towards that. If I can take the example of students coming together, advocating for climate change, have been able to move governments, have been able to move United Nations to pay attention to what they are saying. How did that happen? It started with one student, but it got everyone together. So it's again when that movement is there and when we come together. Think about crowdsourcing. I'll explain a minute what crowdsourcing is. Agar hamari koi ek achhi idea hai aur hum chahte hain ki mujhe ye idea ko aage badhana hai, and I need some support, or in crowdsourcing I need some funds, then I can just put it out there, and kahan se bhi, all over the world, within the country, somebody who knows me or doesn't know me can contribute. Which means I can take help from others. It doesn't have to be, I don't have it, but I can bring others, I can reach out to others to bring it together. So crowdsourcing is also an idea that's become very common in our modern times. And then something like a Wikipedia, which some of you may know is not owned by anybody. Har ek koi usko contribute kar sakta hai, koi bol sakta hai ki ye sahi hai, ye galat hai, and somehow it works. It is really perfect. It has come, all of these examples are really good examples to show that change has happened because we have come together. But in reality, our efforts towards, and if I take example, just thinking, keeping our students at the center, our actions are not as collective as we want to be, especially at a time when possibly we need to work more deeply with the children, right? And this is my personal experience from some of the work that we've done, and some of my experiences as I was going as a teacher. I saw that the school is so important as a school. I thought the system is so important, and then really thinking about how can we bring all of that together. So I wanted to just share an example of what this collaboration can then mean, but also just why that's important for our students, right? I was in a conversation with a few students in a village in Jharkhand, and many un students ko pucha ke, what do you want from the work that we do as this NGO, as the government, as the society? And of course they said ki mujhe mera education complete karna hai, mujhe school jana hai. But they also said that I want better health. I want to know about my how to keep myself healthy, how I can have more energy, nourishment issues, etc. They also want safety. They want to make sure that it's safe enough for them to go to school. And if they go to school, school is also safe. And of course, agency, matlab to give them a voice. Ki unko, unki baat koi sune, unko koi participation, they have a participation, they are involved. Ki koi unko importance de. And then now, what we're also hearing, usko agar main breakdown karo, then there's skills and livelihoods. How can they get a job? What are the kind of skills they know? Sexual reproductive rights and knowledge, that is also important. So there are a lot of, you ask a child or you ask a student, they won't say ki bas mujhe education hi chahiye. They, if you really have a conversation, they'll say they want a lot of things, and it is our duty and our right to provide that for them. But what happens in reality is when we are working, we're often working separately. And let me just take an example of the government also. Right? We have departments. Often, jab hum policies dekhte hain, jo government ki implementation dekhte hain, ek department se dupe department, sometimes there is not a lot of conversation. And success only happens when it all comes together. Education department needs to talk to the health department needs to talk to the safety, etc. So we all have to come together. And when I am speaking about education transformation and collaboration, the underlying thing is that we cannot anymore go by saying that my job is only to provide education, but we have to think about our children in a more holistic, in a more comprehensive way. This is an idea that is not new. It's not something ki humne pehle kabhi suna nahi hai, socha nahi hai, but ye implement itni aasani se nahi hota hai. It's not possible that it is difficult to get everybody to be like, yes, I also want to work on education, I also want to work on health, I also want to work on this. So how do we make that happen? And that is the real challenge. But this part I wanted to leave us with to say that there is a need, and the big changes, like I gave those examples of the of climate change, of crowdsourcing, we are seeing in our modern times, and we've always known that if we combine our efforts, we can do more. I'll pause here, and I would love some comments from the group there to see and you can say plus one or yes or no, if you believe that collaboration is important, or if you think that, yeah, it is important, but it doesn't happen, or maybe it is not important. So yes, no, maybe, if you can leave some comments, would be good for me to know, and then we can chat further. So I'll pause here for whoever's listening in to just answer with a yes, no, maybe on collaboration and this combining of efforts. Great. So I'm seeing that a lot of yes is there, which is, मतलब बहुत सिंपल सी बात है ना, कोई हमको बोले अगर कि चलो साथ में काम करते तो हम मना क्यों करेंगे, लेकिन ये भी सोचने की बात है कि इतना इजीली साथ में काम करना doesn't happen. So let's just see what that would mean. So what is a collaborative effort? And जो मैं example दूंगी वो थोड़ा systemic होगा, मतलब पूरी जब हमको education transform करना है, so we have to really think about all the systems together. So I'm going to talk about all the systems, and then we'll break it down as to what can that mean for you as a teacher, you as a principal, or even as a student. So here's an ideal example, right? We keep the child at the center, all the needs of our children at the center. Then we have on the table the government, कि वो आप जो policies you're crafting, and article, now we are this conference especially, we've been talking so much about NEP, the policies that you have, the policies that you implement, how can they take all the needs of our children into account? Is there enough support and capital, money, to be able to put in the right efforts? How can we bring civil society organizations, schools, teachers, voices into have a conversation, they can also have a dialogue with the government. They can also have a conversation, unki voice and unka conversation also we can take forward. And how can we also bring, and I think just the session before this and one of the tracks we were talking about data and research. How can we have research also become a big part of this? So these are the different key levers that if we bring together on a think about it, ki puri country mein agar ye sari conversations, all of these partners work together with the view ki what do we need to provide for our children, is when we'll begin to make that happen. Abhi kya ho raha hai ki there's somebody else is talking here, some kuch research yahan chal raha hai, kuch NGOs, partners, schools apna tarike se kaam kar rahe hain, kuch ye kar rahe hain, and it's all good work. But if we want to transform and we really need that, we need to come together and we need somebody, an anchor to bring that together. But first is just the idea. First is just understanding ki yes, across the table, we need to bring different folks together. And there are examples. Actually, India mein, agar main thoda sa aapko idea do, to there are at least five to six efforts, not directly in education, but for say for children, for climate change, that are happening that are collaborative like this. Matlab, including the government, including the civil society, including the citizens, they are all coming together on a table to really have a conversation, okay, how can we do what we do well, but also take from you and work together. So let's understand what that can mean, right? It basically means that you, aapko pata hai ki theek hai, meri school mein ya meri classroom mein ya meri community mein, this is the thing that I know I do well. But ye kuch cheeze hai that mujhe support chahiye and I need to bring that from somewhere. So how can I make that happen? How can I get that dialogue going? Like I said, we need some one anchor to do that. And if you are a teacher, you can be that anchor. If you're a school principal, your school can be that anchor, which says ki hamari students ko hamari community mein safety chahiye, health chahiye, education chahiye. Aur ye main kuch examples de rahi hu. It could be ki aapke outcomes kuch alag tarike se focused ho. But say you say ki hamari students ko ye teen char cheeze kaise mil sakti hai. Then who is there in my community who does really good work in health? It could be an NGO, it could be the Mohalla clinic, it could be some doctors. Can the school principal and a doctor come together and have a conversation? Can we also get the local MLA to have a conversation? Can we have parents also in the voice? Then you become a catalyst to say, okay, I'm not just providing education. I'm making sure that everything that my students need gets completed and it is comprehensive. That's how you will transform and that's how you will move there. I want to pause here. I think there are some questions coming, so I'll move to the next slide and then pause and take some of your questions. So before I move to the next one, would be great to take some questions. We have some questions on collaboration within students. I think this is a really good point, and I'd be very happy to answer this. I'll just wait if there are any other questions. We'll take a few and then we can move. I also request the facilitator to let me know about time. Ye topic kafi passionate hai mere liye, to main baat karte jaungi to mujhe time ka bhi andaza nahi rahega. So okay, so we have a couple of questions here. One on just collaboration between students. You know, it is such an important question, I think, that you have asked. As humans, they will always say ki we want network, we want to work with others. As mankind, humne koi bhi kaam akele baithke hume kabhi maza nahi aaya. We always want to be around, community, family, people. So it is in our DNA as such. Lekin ho kya jata hai, when we create an atmosphere, we start comparing, we start saying you versus you, you versus you, then we start focusing on individual efforts. And I think the way to break out of that is to force some collaboration. And collaboration to make that happen, which then brings me to the next, this is to a little bit the first question. What is the shared goal? So you need to provide a goal or have the students come up with something common that they want to work on, either for their school, either for their community, or either for something even bigger. Once there is a shared goal, then tumhare jo hamare jo alag alag agendas hai na, wo matter karna kam karte hain. Then it doesn't matter, because we have only one this ke actually mujhe jo chahiye wo matter nahi karta. Wo jo matter karta hai ki humne jo goal hamare liye set kiya hai wo hum kaise achieve kar paaye. Therefore it always is better that we co-create the goal. Then there are different agendas, but they matter less, and you have to almost force people, especially students and adults. It is, you have to create the structures. Aisa nahi hai ki ek din khud hi matlab they will start working. We have to make time, we have to give the space to make that happen. It could be through one lesson at the end of the day, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, you have a session to say ki okay, what is it that bothering us in our community, what is it that we want to change in our classroom, how can we work together. Then we have to ask, theek hai, to be able to do that, am I the only one who can make it happen? Who are the other players and actors that I need to engage? If it is my local MLA, it is my school principal, it is my supervisor, it is the other students, who is it that are the actors, who are the anchors that I need to engage? And then finally, who is the sutradhar? Who is the main anchor? They have to sort of decide that as well. So those are the few questions, and I would say through that you get the conversation going. I know we are running out of time, so I just want to I think end at just this. Just think about who's at the center, which is the shared goal, and who you can collaborate with. So what do you bring, which is your strength? Your strength could also be ki mera kaam hai sirf logon ko saath mein lana. That is also a very difficult skill. See, not everybody is very good at it. Ki apne aapka agenda kam karo, lekin what is important is ke baki sab log saath mein aaye. So maybe that is your skill, in which case you are a great anchor. So identifying that, what are the shared goals? So apne agendas ko nahi, lekin hamara common agenda kya hai? Ek bar wo decide ho gaya, then it's a lot easy to make this collaboration happen. And I think collaboration is the key to this transformation. For a long time, we often get focused on going deeper in our work. What we don't realize is what we are missing out. And I think that would be one thing that I would leave everyone today here with, is if we can build that thinking of collaboration right from the beginning, then change is possible. I'll pause here, see if anyone has any last questions, thoughts. I'd be happy to answer. Otherwise, it was really great speaking to all of you. Thank you so much for making the time, and thank you to the Inspired team as well.
Thank you so much, Shrutika. I think those were the questions that came up on the chat box. These were the few questions that had come up. So thank you so much for being here.
No, thank you so much. My pleasure.
Delighted to have you here. Even the topic of collaboration, I think, not only for teaching profession, for any profession, is extremely important. The skill to have. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you.